I can't imagine like my freshman year, like my first semester here without this course. And I think it's given me a lot of like confidence and like gotten me really excited about just like the next 4 years in general.
In the class, the students are learning about the engineering design process. They're learning about each of the steps of the process, and then they're applying them right away to whatever their project is. So the clients came to us with authentic problems, things that they really needed to be solved that these freshman engineers could take on. So the five projects that I coached were the automated bear feeders for the Museum of Life and Science, the drone-mounted water sampler for the Duke Marine Lab, the brainwave headset testing device for NeuroPlus, and the acetic acid applicator integrated into a pocket colposcope for Duke researchers. One of our clients is the Duke Gardens. So cold frames house the plant seedlings.
We have been automating the system that opens and closes the cold frames based on temperature. So basically we're gonna have temperature sensors sensing the temperature outside, and then a lot of just electrical and like coating components. And then that'll decide whether or not the frames should be open or closed. And then we'll have a winch up top that'll be like pulling them open or closed.
We worked with the Duke Pulmonary Clinic to develop an attachment to a walker to hold three oxygen tanks. One project worked with a young woman with cerebral palsy, and that team developed a fork, a spoon, and a plate for her so that she could eat independently. We worked with the Duke Lemur Center to develop a feeding platform for lemurs that's higher up in the trees than their current designs. One project was with the Ellerbee Creek Watershed Association, and this team designed a device to be placed in the creek that catches floating trash. One team partnered with the nursing school to develop a better mannequin.
So that was a great fit because we do have a lot of our equipment that doesn't work as well as we'd like. Just the way the manufacturers make them, they're not very realistic. So we talked about various topics, and we ended up talking about an arm which students practice to put IVs in.
So right now, the IV mannequin skin is kind of rubbery, and when you poke a needle, you can easily see kind of where the old needle was. So it's really easy for the next nursing student to come in and get the IV inserted correctly. So this team's job was to develop a more authentic skin, as well as a kind of a soft frame to hold the vessels kind of appropriately placed underneath the skin. That team has been very successful. They actually went to the nursing school and did some testing with some nursing students.
So back home, like, I knew that I wanted to make medical devices. I knew probably that I wanted to make prosthetic arms. So going home and being able to say, like, I got to make an arm, like, right from the get-go, and that's literally my dream. So getting to go back and tell the people who knew that was my dream, that I actually got to, like, have a taste of it, is getting really exciting.
In order to solve their engineering design challenges, most teams had to do engineering calculations. Fortunately, we have a suite of technical mentors, faculty and graduate students in the School of Engineering who are able to come in and support the teams to provide some of the technical expertise necessary to solve the problems. The culmination of the course is a poster session with prototype display. So the clients in the community, technical mentors, as well as faculty and staff from Pratt are invited to the space to see the fantastic work that the students have completed.
Each project has its own viewpoint and its own perspective pertaining to different fields of engineering, and it caters to everybody's interest, whether it be current interest, future interest, career goals. It helps to teach concepts in those fields and develop teamwork skills and communication skills and an all-encompassing range of knowledge that an engineer would need in industry.
So it's cool that they're giving freshmen the opportunity to have this design course and like give them experience early on, so then they can continue to apply it throughout instead of just like learning everything and then just like applying it at the end.
So some students, when they're in Pratt, it's, of course, it's very difficult at first. So they might lose confidence, but this class helps you gain confidence. And then, do you remember what it's called? It's called self-something.
Self-efficacy.
There you go.